Here we go with some examples from the four most prominent albums which you should all listen and try to understand and analyze and eventually play with them and take the juice out of them of the Paco de Lucía's discography with Camarón de la Isla, most prominent singer of the Deep Sea Line. And here we have the intros ad libitum, or starting with the singer without any tempo, and then piece will begin. So let's go with this example one here from the album Como el Agua. This is number one. Then let's go to another one, which is for Alegrías.
Veré el camino, fuente de piedra, cantar y llover.
Okay, let's go with another one from the same album, example number three. Okay, it started earlier, but it's, again, at the beginning had this ad libitum part. Now let's go to next very ultra super prominent album. This he advised me to try to analyze it very carefully, and I did. And this is one thing that is missing nowadays in Spain. People don't know this. Let's check from the Calle Real, from the great album Calle Real, a couple of examples of same intros ad libitum. Electric bass, amazing piece. Okay, this is another instance, and now we have other one more. Let's go with this second example from the Calle Real album. Now let's go to the album, last album they did together, Potro de Rabia y Miel, which is, I will post the four links of these albums for you at the description of this video, and I want you to listen them carefully. If you're a student in CWD, you need to know this music and as a reference for harmony, etc. Okay, let's go with the Potro de Rabia y Miel, Eres como un laberinto, one other track, different, which also has had an intro ad libitum. Here we go. Wait a second, I confused this track with this one. which is Calle de los Lunares, this here. Interesting thing, because it's part of the style of Paco de Lucía's style to do that, and that's why I do it in this on those multi-screen videos. I will also post in the description those which I made, which have these ideas as well. And then one more, which of course this is a seguidilla, and we could consider it also an intro ad libitum somehow. It's an orchestration by John Albert Amargos, and this is one of the most important albums by Paco as well. Again, I will post in the description. This will be our last example for now. On Ad Libitum Intros of Cante, four pieces, flamenco, other flamenco guitar. Also revolutionary, because this here, Paco, and this arrangement orchestration by John Albert Amargos, it was the first time that the cante flamenco was done with orchestra, with an orchestra accompanying. So very interesting thing, and these materials will be useful for your complete understanding of the modern flamenco music.